The following is a presentation of TFNN. Time to talk about your health. Living a primal lifestyle.
You know, we have Tom on from Tampa on the phone. Hey, Tom. Good morning. It's bright and early now, huh?
Hey, thanks.
Good. Hi, Tom.
How you guys doing, Nico?
Doing great.
Good. Hey, your newsletter's outstanding, man. I'm telling you, man, it is outstanding. And so is the Primal Edge. I love that stuff. I'd never be without it. I mean, I've been on it now 3-4 months, man. I mean, it's just, I can't get over how good I feel.
Primal Edge is, people are raving about it. People who are trying it, they know because you can feel it.
We'd not be without it.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now your hosts, Nico DeHaan and Paige Clarke.
Well, good morning and welcome to Living a Primal Lifestyle. I'm Paige Clarke, and this is where we explore a return to a more balanced, natural, wild world.
To recover our natural health and regain some of our rights and freedoms. And I'm Nico DeHaan.
And it's beautiful here today. It's 61. We're having fun. Hope you are too. And, you know, if you have any questions, you can email me at paige@tfnn.com.
Or me, Nico@tfnn.com. And, of course, we're taking your phone calls at 877-927-6648.
Well, it looks like we've got an interesting show today, Nico. Some of the stuff that you were sending back and forth. You know, Nico and I do that all week. We're kind of both of us ferocious readers, ferocious consumers of information. And we do this because we want to know how we can live a healthier life. And we want to share it with the people that are listening to our show.
Yeah, we really have a passion for trying to seek out this information because my passion has always been, you know, I want to be healthy when I'm in old age.
How to live longer, stronger, healthier, and that is living wealthier.
Yeah, that's for sure. So the last few weeks, we've been talking about what we've been consuming.
Yeah.
And how it affects us. And I thought today we'd go down and talk really about what the animals are eating now.
I think that's going to be great. And also kind of midway through the show, we're going to have infrared earth energy and water expert Robbie Bessner join us.
Right.
There's been some current events that are talking a little bit about, you know, what's going on. You know, we ought to always be concerned about our water.
Yep.
I mean, that was probably the most precious resource to our ancestors, obviously.
I think so.
Can't sustain life no matter what we're eating.
That's for sure.
You got to have good water.
And the state of the water today is not good. I mean, remember the summer, we had all those algae blooms. We had the spills because the
storms. We covered that pretty extensively. Yeah.
Yeah, and, you know, that's very disturbing things. And one of the things that I started back in 1969 in the old hippie days is drinking distilled water.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I've never had any other water besides distilled water since then, really.
And then what we're going to kind of learn is that nature, you know, actually distills water, but then it does certain actions, you know.
Yes.
That's what the whole concept of Theraguds and why I love talking with Robbie and learning about water, because I like distilled water, I like spring water. That what I learned from one of my other water researchers,
mm-hmm.
and I think you and I had him on the show where we talked, but is that almost any water could be the best water or it can be the worst water for you.
Depends how it's structured. Yeah.
Depending on if it's got structure, if it's got surface tension,
yeah.
and if it's been able to absorb the natural radiation from the sun.
And the good thing is nature does this naturally, and we look at waterfalls in awe. And this is an inspiration. When you see a waterfall, you go, wow, even if it's a small one, it's always cool to see running water, especially nice, clear, crystal clear, cool water.
I agree with you, and that's that vortexing, that movement's part of it. But we're going to get to that after Robbie, but let's talk a little bit about what we put together here.
So, well, one of the things is, you know, when I think of animals on a farm, I think mm-hmm. about the rolling hills and animals eating the grass, little fences around.
That's how it is
things.
In Austria.
Yeah, and, you know, that's the way I grew up. And going across Canada and across the United States when I was young, this is what we always saw. And I think we still see a lot of farmland out there. We don't see a lot of animals on it anymore as much. We're starting to see that come back. But over the last 50 years, the way animals are raised and fed has changed dramatically. And it's you're probably surprised to find out that the food animals in the United States eat, they're not really out in the farm anymore. They're
it's
factories.
It's an industrial process. It's factory farming.
Yeah, kind of
so
like an assembly line.
It's not that little vision that you see on your milk carton with
no.
the little cows with the sun.
Yeah, and the first thing is not the food. It's the confinement. Here, animals are really made to run around. And if you've ever seen some of those YouTube videos in Sweden when they let the cows out of the barn after a long winter,
I remember you telling me this.
Yeah, this is great.
And then they were leaping.
Oh, they're leaping in the air. They're rubbing themselves on the grass like this is heaven all of a sudden. And of course, they were just kept in for the winter. Now imagine animals that have been kept in these factories and never go outside. I mean, they don't know what outside is.
They really haven't. They've been raised from birth. It's just a whole other energy mindset. I mean, that's what I like to explain to people. These animals are in their milk, in their meat. This is actually, this whole terrible treatment is kind of being transferred.
There's also plenty of YouTube videos of animals like tigers and different kinds of monkeys and things like that have been brought up in labs for testing, and finally they let them out.
Never have lived in the wild.
Never have lived in the wild, and then all of a sudden they're touching the soft ground that they don't even know what that is, and they're very reluctant, and it takes them a while to get, oh, freedom. Wait a minute, there's nothing over my head, that type of thing.
Yeah.
Very sad thing.
It's like Joel Salatin, you know, our farmer that we love in Virginia, right near where I'm from.
Yeah.
He says, folks, this just ain't normal.
That's right. I love that guy.
I do, too. That's just fun to watch him.
Yeah, so just like other factories, animal factories are constantly searching for ways to cut costs. This is the reason why you jam a whole bunch of things in a small space. You want to save a cost. And it's easier to feed them. And, of course, they're going to be fed what you want them to feed them. But also, they're forced to eat that. In other words, they're not roaming around finding their own food.
Yeah.
Which is what animals do. So their natural instinct, you're cutting that off right away. That's even without looking at the food that they're feeding them. And this is really the shocking part to me, is the confinement, not allowing them to be in the fresh air, not going through their natural patterns of behavior, which is migration. Of course, we cut that out on a farm, too.
There's just nothing normal about their life.
There is nothing
and
normal.
And the ingredients that are used in this feed these days are not the kind of food, as Nico said, that
That's
the animals eat. Just take a look at those guys. Same species meat. Folks, that just ain't normal. I don't think many of us can even imagine that that's kind of part of what happens. You know, that's not even
natural
in the food
chain. Until I read it, I really didn't think about that part of it. You never think about a cow eating a cow, or a chicken eating a chicken, or a pig eating a pig. Maybe a pig, you know, because pigs can eat anything.
But it's still just doesn't seem normal. You think more of the chain.
Yeah.
The food chain.
But it's also lawful for them to eat diseased animals.
They can just take the diseased animals and put it into the feed. The feathers, hair, skin, hoofs, and blood of other animals.
Yeah.
Manure and other animal waste.
Yeah, and then, of course, you find the things that we're manufactured and maybe used in carrying the feed. We find plastics. We find, of course, drugs and chemicals in the feed. Also, they use a lot of drugs besides just the food. In other words, the food is making them sick, so now we need antibiotics.
Because they're eating what they're not supposed to, so there's an unhealthy amount of grains. And, you know, how do you fatten up a piece of livestock animal?
Right.
You're going to feed them grains. So that's what's happening to the American people. They're feeding their herd.
And unfortunately, all this stuff that we just mentioned is legal.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And it's not the right thing, though. It's not what they're supposed to be eating.
We're up on a break here, so I'd like to remind people, first of all, take some Primal Edge this morning, please. And you can get this for $89 a month. Get it right to your door every single month. And this is probably the best way to start the day. If you're out there trading or if you got another thing to do, this is really the best way to start this. And we talked about this last night at the TFNN party.
Exactly. Just like the picture shows, you know, you're getting Earth's minerals, which is the food and nutrients that we were designed to need.
That's right. Also, please pick up our Health Signals newsletter. I've got a great, great article about the efficiency of different bulbs and what causes migraines and what's unhealthy as far as light is concerned. Big concern these days because the lights are changing.
Remember I told you that's the one thing that got me kicked off Facebook for sharing that. Can you believe it?
Yeah, I believe it. Crazy. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning. Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you'll lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Nico and Paige take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
And welcome back to the show, folks. So we're really talking about what animals are eating and how perhaps we've lost sight of really how to treat animals, and we've really lost their natural ability to move around. That's the first thing we did hundreds of years ago. We put up fences so these animals can't roam anymore. In fact, the cow doesn't have any of that in them anymore. And that's one of the wonderful things about these large herds of animals across every continent.
We're in their wild, that we're allowed to roam.
They were allowed to roam, and that's what made them healthy, and that's what made us healthy, because we're eating them because of the spirit of them. This is what the American Indian, the Plains Indian, always said, the spirit of the animal is so important.
They could not even fathom the American settlers in their use of the domestic cow. They were blown away by that.
They thought it was an inferior type of animal.
And a cruelty? Yeah, everything. They just didn't appreciate it at all.
And this was at a time, remember, in the mid-1800s when this was going on, and these cattle were still roaming. But they were roaming because we pushed them, not because they were doing it on their own. But still, these were what we would call today the best meat we could get is from a steer that's eating grass.
Right. And free to eat what it wants.
And American Indian thought this was an inferior animal. And now, of course, we come to the state where now we have them in these factories, the CAFOs, the caged.
Confined animal feeding operations. Right. And as a result, what have we seen? The advent of diseases such as mad cow.
Yeah.
It's also known as bovine spongiform encephalopathy.
Yeah, and this really was a worldwide phenomenon. This was discovered, I think, in the United States. Mm-hmm. And the federal government took action really to restrict parts of the cattle that can be fed back to the cattle. You know, it's still legal for them to feed them still cows. It's just certain parts.
Yeah,
so like the intestines and stuff like that.
Yeah, it's just
but it still
right.
doesn't make much sense to me. Under current law, pigs, chickens, turkeys have been fed, rendered cattle.
And can fed back to those same animals.
Yeah, so they can be rendered again and then fed back to the cattle to infect healthy cattle. So it's really animal feed is legally can contain rendered roadkill, dead horses, euthanized cats and dogs.
Well, and this is a perfect example because so many people who have adopted a vegan lifestyle or a vegetarian lifestyle for very many reasons, and rightly so.
And this is one of the reasons.
This is probably the foremost reason, and I understand it.
Well, sure, we have the same concerns.
We have the same concerns, and that's a key point, that if we believe that there's optimal nutrition in mindfully, sparingly having some animal foods, animal dense foods, but having it in an appreciative way where the animals are raised in their natural environment. Because we are not just what we eat, we're what we eats.
Right? That's for sure.
You know?
That's for sure. Other things can be like rendered feathers, hair, skin, hooves, blood, intestines can be found in feed, often under a catch-all category like animal protein products.
Mm-hmm.
Manure and other animal waste, they can be in this. Even poultry litter. So in other words, the litter that they use for the poultry in the cages, they can sweep that up, put it into the...
Just use it almost like a meal or a binder or filler in the food.
Yeah.
There you go. That's lots of fillers. You know, even with your pets, folks. We're not just talking about the livestock that we eat, but think about your pets. And I know I like to tell people, think about your pets, because most of them treat their pets almost better than they do their other family members or themselves sometimes, and they're members of the family.
Well, they certainly are. And, when something happens to your pet, man, you really feel it just like your child.
Absolutely.
It's a traumatic
thing.
But
a lot of people are not aware, too, that what's in their food is very much of this same industrialized food chain.
Yeah, so, and you can really look at the food, too, in a way that, there's no animal that really eats wheat.
Oh, yeah.
Only birds eat seeds to begin with.
Yeah, you know, that's something. Let's go to that real quick. What animals eat wheat?
I don't know of any.
They're eating wheat because we're giving it to them.
That's the
only
way.
But in the natural environment, would they even bother eating
wheat? So your pets are, this is just much a concern for your pets is what you're feeding them. And we've talked a long time about the Pottinger's cats. We've talked about dogs that have been starting to fed their natural food, which is really raw meat, mm-hmm. and all their problems clear up.
Yeah, well, and Pottinger showed that when they took the cats after a few generations, the species really had a lowered fertility rate and a lower lifespan. I wonder if you take a look at the human species, what's happened since we've introduced foods that were not part of the regular diet. So these are all things that are wonderful. Here's something here. Just to kind of summarize it, horses, cows, pigs, rabbits only eat grain when they're fed it by humans. Who are we to think that we should be deciding what these animals eat? Normally they would eat leaves from pasture and other vegetables.
Yeah, and this is relatively a modern thing. Feeding cattle grains was done mostly when agriculture started and only in the wintertime. Because the grass wasn't around, so
it probably wouldn't be quite as detrimental. Give them a little bit of a grain while you're milking.
Well, it used to be the hay long time ago. That's what they had, which is the dead grass, and that's really good for cows, and it actually fattens them up more because it's more carbohydrate. The protein is a little wasted on it. The other thing is too is that so the grains that we feed the animals are really detrimental because it's not their natural food and because they also have a hard time digesting it just like we do. I mean, cows can digest plant food, but we really don't consider grains a plant food. It's actually a pre-food.
Right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's not a plant yet. It's a seed. It's held in stasis.
Mm-hmm.
So,
And then you see all this inflammatory diseases and so forth. I mean, quite frankly, my Qigong teacher made a real good point when he was talking about, we were learning about A1 dairy and A2 dairy. Normally A2 dairy would be like goat's milk is naturally A2.
Right.
It's the classification of the casein molecule, the protein molecule. And it was like, really, when you stop and you take a look at a dairy cow or mm-hmm. a cow, she's very estrogenic, kind of lots of body fat, mm-hmm. moves slow, sweet, And then you look at a goat, mountain goat, and he's testosterone-y and lean and, agile. So
can take care of himself.
Yeah, you start to think of kind of just by the way they're fed. What's a goat usually doing? They're grazing.
Yeah.
And cows today are not being allowed to graze that way.
While grain may sound like a healthy food, the excessive quantities fed to some animals are not. This is especially true for cattle, which are naturally grass eaters. Their digestive systems are not designed to handle large amounts of corn they receive in the feedlots. As a result of this corn-rich diet, feedlot cattle can suffer significant health problems, including excessively acid digestive systems and liver abscesses. Grain-induced health problems, in turn, ramp up the need for drugs.
So which then starts the antibiotic of the animal, which then keeps it in the food supply.
Yeah, and have you seen, seen some of the pictures of actually the
handlers reaching in
the, reaching into the stomach about every 10th cow or something like that, has a hole in their stomach so they can reach in and test how much antibiotic is in there and whether other bacteria is in there.
Yeah.
So
we got a break coming up, but we're going to have Robbie Bessner, Chief Science Officer for Theraguds. We're going to talk about water, and we're going to talk a little bit about an article, kind of close to our home. You know, we talked about the algae blooms, but Florida Power and Light has won a battle to store radioactive waste under Miami's drinking water.
Excellent.
That could be coming to a city near you. You should be paying attention, pay close attention. So we'll pick Robbie's brain when we get right back. So make sure and give us a call if you have some questions, 877-927-6648. See you right after the break.
We'd like to tell you about the personal training studio that Nico is the owner and president of, Performance Training. Since 1998, Nico has trained individuals and groups to improve their health both mentally and physically. As a certified personal trainer, Nico's main focus is on demonstrating exercises correctly to avoid injury and teaching his clients how to manage their past injuries while getting the most out of their personal training sessions. The Performance Training Studio is filled with unique training equipment that enhances balanced results at a faster rate while minimizing damage and discomfort. For more information, you can give Nico a call at 727-418-8740 or email him at nico@tfnn.com. Let him know you heard him on TFNN and save up to $100 on a special package just for TFNN listeners. Act today.
Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video, giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And welcome back, guys. I think we've got Robbie Bessner out there. Robbie, are you on the line? Sounds like Al's trying to get him set up. I can't hear him yet, but we're going to talk a little bit about this article that's says that the Florida Power and Light Company has just won a battle to store radioactive waste under Miami's drinking water aquifer. And, you know, I see something like that, and I'm kind of like, what are we thinking? Are we thinking that if we just tuck stuff underneath, you know, it's like stuffing
crazy.
It underneath a rug or putting it under the covers, you know? And so a lot of environmental activists have started to urge people to sign a petition that would encourage Florida lawmakers to prevent them from storing this waste underground, because South Florida sits atop two gigantic underground stores of water, the mm-hmm. Biscayne and the Florida aquifers.
Right.
And most Miami area people get their drinking water from the Upper Biscayne Aquifer, while the government has used the lower portion of the Floridian to dump waste and untreated sewage. But despite this fact, multiple studies have warned that the waste could one day seep into the drinking water. And, you know, again, we've kind of made a shift and realized, well, even the drinking water we get from plastic water bottles, we think it's clean, but then it gets recontaminated with over 24,000 toxic plastic chemicals. Mm-hmm. We get it through our tap, supposed to be clean. We know that it's not, and there's things wrong with it, but, you know, what are we going to do? Yeah. Robbie, are you out there?
Can you hear me okay?
Oh, now
hey,
we can see you. Okay,
there
great.
You are. Cool.
Cool.
Okay, I wasn't sure. good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Well, Robbie, you know, you live in that area in South Florida, so tell us what you know. Should we be storing radioactive waste underneath our aquifers?
Well, it's pretty scary because, you know, there's been a whole reaction to the radioactive waste from Japan that's come over through the seas. That's just in the air and the seas. Now we're talking about containing. You really can't contain this stuff too well. And as we've experienced even from the municipal water systems like in Flint, Michigan, and, you know, where you've got these pipes that are corroding, I mean, over time it might work for the short term, but the long term, what are you going to do with this waste when it starts leaching into the water? And, I mean, you know, it's not a new study on the effects of these kinds of energies, high-intense energies, on the way that it actually structures the water and makes it, you know, not very, very, besides the potential of cancers and all the things that are going to come out from it, just from an energetic point of view, the structure, the radioactive energy actually destructures the water and makes it very hard for the body to actually hydrate, the cell to hydrate well. So, you know, it's any way, any angle you look at it, it's not a pretty picture from my point of view.
Yeah, you know, what really is odd about this, Robbie, is that I don't see any containment plans if there is a spill. I mean, they don't have any contingency plans at all. I mean, how would you clean that up?
I don't know. You know, look at the trouble, the billions they spend on oil spills that happen.
Right.
I mean, that stuff, and that's things you can see. But what about the radioactive hazmat potential here is just enormous.
Yeah.
And I think that's a great point, Robbie, because what you find out is that because radiation, you can't see it, you can't touch it, you can't mm-hmm. feel it. It's kind of like something they just shove under the rug. And, you know, Rachel Carlson in her famous book, The Silent Spring, she's probably rolling over, right? With
oh,
all
yeah.
Of that.
Yeah, I'm
yeah,
sure.
I have some, I think I mentioned this the other day, Paige. I have some friends in the San Francisco Bay Area, and they say that their pets, just from the rain that's radioactive and has acid based on it, oh, this is all based on radiation, it's actually wearing the pads of the paws of the animals that are, you know, walking on the streets and so forth down so that they're actually, you know, they're bleeding and they're, you know, I mean, it's really got a physiological effect. And of course, as we all know in nature, it always affects the animals and the ecosystems before we, on top of the food chain, you know, start to react to it. So
yeah.
I think this is truly an ounce of prevention. We really have to be very, very, very careful with this.
Yeah,
one.
You know, I was reading an article on Chernobyl and how the animals there are really thriving, the wolves and the vols, and they've been doing testing on different generations of these vols, which are just small little animals like squirrels, I guess, or groundhogs. But, I mean, these animals are living, they're thriving, but they are radioactive.
Okay.
So here we're really starting an almost a new species of animal, and now as these animals grow and spread into different areas, we really don't know what the response would be.
Yeah, we don't.
Right, and then I mean, just earlier on your segment about all the ways that grains and foods and and these various different chemicals that are put into the feeds in the animals and how that affects the foods that we're eating. Now add the whole spin on radioactivity to the picture, because the animals are going to pick that up first, and then ultimately it comes into our food supplies. So.
And you know, Robbie, let me just interject here too, because you've been cutting edge on all of these things. As one of the foremost researchers and developers of infrared technology, infrared does help us to detoxify. It helps us detoxify from chemicals. It helps us detoxify from heavy metals. And it actually can really help our bodies deal with the stress of that silent radioactivity. And one of the things that we're talking about the quality of our water, what we have to do. Theragoods has a filtration system that helps to help us deal with the possible insult of radiation, correct? By having the infrared spectrum in the water filtration. Can you just give a little highlight?
Yeah, well, actually, I pulled a slide, but I don't know how well you're going to be able to see this. Can you guys see this on the screen?
Oh yeah, well, it's like the Emoto. That's the Emoto crystal.
Yeah, exactly. So on one side you see what water would look like, unstructured and the effects of radiation, and the other side is what happens in nature, which is what we all think about when we think about a snowflake. And
right.
So this is what we're dealing with. This is not biocompatible, and obviously this is something that the body and the energetics of the body will get into the cell and actually hydrate us the right way. And, Paige, what you mentioned, what we did as a company, and just, off the back of all of our infrared science and applied sciences, and infrared frequencies are an extraction of sun energy. And these are the healing frequencies that will help the body detoxify from radiation and all the other environmental poisons would be some kind of infrared therapy. It doesn't have to be a sauna or a healing pad or any of those products per se. You can get it from natural sunlight. If you're there, if you're in the sun when the infrared spectrum is available, which is usually early afternoon to dusk time frame. And on the water side, it's about structure, and the radiation will break down the structure and give you that muddy look, whereas when you bring the infrared frequency, it restructures the water, which is what we've installed in our technology with our purification system. And so essentially, whatever water is coming through the municipal system, if it goes through our purification last before you drink it, it's going to be structured and great for the body.
Awesome. We're up on a break, Robbie, so stick around, folks. We got Robbie here talking about water and talking about what insane stuff is happening in
Glad
Miami.
Thanks
right
for
back.
Having me.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated fulvic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning. Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
And welcome back to the show. I'm looking at this article here, Robbie, and what it's talking about is that there's an area right in the Biscayne Bay area, which is an aquifer. An aquifer to me means that the water goes up from a spring, right, which means that if there is a leak, this stuff comes to the surface. And the other thing that I'm concerned about in this is there's a lot of tectonic, it's a tectonic area. There's slip zones there, what they call different types of zones where the earth does move. And of course, we know it's limestone, pretty fragile area. They call it hermetically sealed. This stuff is going to be from the Turkey plant. This doesn't sound like it's a good thing at all.
Yeah, this guy White says the evidence is so strong that it's double doubtful that the zone is hermetically sealed.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, the whole scenario is a bad scenario.
Yeah.
You know, honestly. Yeah. And why people aren't, you know, these laws and ordinances get muscled through, and FPL has such a big hold in lobbyists from a lobby point of view here in the Florida area. It's very hard to fight them, and they just power through as they're doing now.
Yeah.
And ultimately, who pays the price, right?
We do, and we always do. I mean, that's the way it always has to work. So these things have to be really thought through. And the idea of nuclear power is it's an enticing one because it's pretty clean, except for the unclean part.
Let's put it that way. Yeah, exactly. You know? Right. It's clean except for the unclean
part.
Yeah,
and I think they're getting better. In fact, what I'm reading now is that this real small reactors are probably the best way to go. And this is what is starting to happen around the world. They're really talking about these smaller reactors and the breeder reactors, which can actually eat their own stuff in a sense. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of like the cows. We were talking about eating their own cows, but the nuclear industry has a way of kind of recycling it, but only in small reactors. Do you know anything about that, Robbie?
Actually, not as much that I'd like to be able to comment on at this point.
Yeah.
But I think that smaller is probably better, and there's lots of other alternative ways to produce power that need to be investigated. That have been around for, you know, and been sort of kept underground for many years. You know, Nikola Tesla was probably the one that's the most notable in being able to create, you know, electricity. And that was the big conflict years ago between Edison and Tesla in terms of the technology. And
yeah, it was DC versus AC, really.
Yeah, and they couldn't figure out a way to monetize natural energy that Tesla did. So, of course, they went with the money.
Right.
So, you know.
And the other thing, too, is that we use way too much electricity, and we got lights on all over the place, all over the world, all the time, which really detracts from our health. And the natural world is a dark place many times, and I think we need to discover that part of it, too.
Well, you know, this is another discussion, and it's probably more than we can take on this show, but we are so far removed from the way that we were, you know, years ago, Jesus, Moses, and Buddha days, you know?
And
before those.
Yeah, and the further we get away from that, it seems like, and, you know, we call it advancement in culture, but the further we get away from those natural events, it seems like the sicker we're getting as societies and cultures in general, right?
Yeah.
True. And, you know, as you know, Robbie, Nico and I often talk about following the sun, you know, the timing of the sun, that our natural chronobiology is important in kind of, you know, the old early to bed, early to rise. It makes sense that using the electromagnetic spectrum of the sun as a guide, but also it's probably the healthiest thing for us. So I want to make sure people understand a point we made right before the break. Nico and I were talking about it when we were on the break. As you said, the electromagnetic spectrum restructures water. We are bags of water.
Certainly are.
So that's why all these years that we were told solar radiation is bad for us, no, we need the solar radiation to restructure the cells, the water in our bodies. So what I'm hearing you say is that every day if we take the time to deliver ourselves water as nature intended, i.e. energized, restructured by the power of the electromagnetic frequencies through the technology you have in these water filtration systems, we're restructuring the body's water without getting sun, in effect. I mean, obviously, we want to get in the sun, too, but this is powerful.
Kind of like grounding ourselves, in a way, with water.
Totally.
Yeah.
Absolutely. There's no doubt about
That's
it.
That's pretty cool.
That earth charge, that vibration is so important. And we kind of discount it. And you said it earlier, because we can't hear it, smell it, taste it, you know, see it. And these energy forces really make the difference between the full absorption or partial absorption. And I think that that this hydration, we're a nation that drinks a whole lot of water, but yet if you go out and test people on the street, the first thing that people, you know, that is present is the fact that they're dehydrated. And when you're dehydrated, as an organism, as an animal, you know, everything that goes on inside the physiology happens at a much faster rate. So the water is so key for the cell to actually properly regulate. And, you know, when you remove the energetics, when you put things like radiation, as we were talking earlier, into the water, so the body is actually, you know, refusing it in a different way, we're moving again further away from the way nature intended us all to be and to work symbiotically together, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, that's
the conclusion
right
of this article. It says Florida Power and Light contends that any radioactive waste discharges will be carefully monitored to ensure they won't leak.
Yeah,
but
right.
The company's credibility with the public is not in good shape. Earlier last year, Miami-Dade County officials said cooling canals from the Turkey Point were already leaking waste into the Biscayne Bay. And the ordeal, I guess they had to go to court, and it led to a lawsuit. So stuff is already spilling into the bay, so their record is not that good.
Sure, and you and I are going to be the first ones on the block to get those reports sent to our houses when there are, you know, some leakages and so forth that we can all talk about, right?
Yeah.
Well, listen, as we're starting to wrap this segment up, Robbie, you know, it was always great to have you on here, and, you know, you're going to be a regular contributor keeping us on the pulse of this. But I want people to understand they can go to theragoods.com, and because it's in pre-launch, I guess, the countertop and also the pitcher, very affordable, you know, $77 or so filter pitcher. Available with free shipping, and an extra filter is going to be available during this pre-launch period. Is that right?
I believe so. Yeah, I don't pay much attention to that economic side. I'm more on the science side, but I believe that is.
Well, anyway, people can reach you through us, and so if you send an email to Paige at Paige@TFNN.com or me, Nico at TFNN.com, we'll send the information out to our listeners and. They'll give all the news on that.
So thanks for joining us, Robbie, and we'll be in touch again. And thanks for keeping us up to date on important things we need, like our water. So we'll see you soon.
Yeah, for sure. Thanks a lot.
Okay.
You got it, guys. Take care. Have a great day. Thank you.
Very interesting. And
he's always great to have on.
Yeah, and, you know, water, big problems when we're talking about just along the coastlines with the red tides, with the algae blooms.
And like he said, if we're dehydrated, you can be eating the best food. You can be taking the best supplements. If you're not getting hydration to the cells so the cells can get the good stuff in, bad stuff out, not going to happen.
And that's for sure.
We have to take a quick break.
Yeah. We'll be right back, folks. Mm-hmm.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a two-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your two-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
No matter where you're listening to TFNN programming, you can always access your favorite shows on demand through TFNN.com. TFNN airs live programming every market day from 8 a.m. till 6 p.m. Eastern, and you can view each program by accessing Tiger TV through our homepage. We even have an easy link for all mobile devices, including iPhones, iPads, and Android devices, located in the top right-hand corner of the TFNN homepage. You can use your smartphone to view Tiger TV. But if you don't have a connection that can keep up with streaming live video, then you can simply visit tfnn.mobi in the browser of your smartphone for live streaming audio of all our programs. The mission of TFNN is to educate our audience directly and interactively through our interactive website and call-in talk shows. TFNN is able to teach all levels of investors the technical skills needed to trade in today's marketplace. In order to get the best information possible, TFNN has assembled the most respected financial minds in the country to provide the most current news and comprehensive advice available. TFNN.com, educating investors. Join John Logan as he teaches you trading techniques utilizing the TAS Profile Scanner. The Global Market Pulse, next on TFNN.
And welcome back. You know, we just had Robbie Vestner on. We were talking a little bit about water. I want to kind of wrap up this session. We hit on a really strong point is why, despite some people drinking a lot of water, why are we still 80% of us chronically dehydrated? And, you know, people are talking about hydration, and many more people are moving away from the sodas and the extra drinks. I think people are starting to wise up about it, and that's a good thing. But most of us are still not aware that we remain, even though we're drinking water, we're drinking what researchers are now calling bulk water. Okay. And bulk water is the H2O form. Mm-hmm. But what the body really wants is what we call now next level water, which is H3O2. Okay, that's the structured water that Robbie was telling us about. That's what the water becomes. It becomes microclustered. It separates out the hydrogen because we need in water contrary to what you've been told, we're not drinking water because we need to get minerals in water, you know, i.e. spring water and so forth. Mm-hmm. We're drinking water because we need two essential elements, hydrogen and oxygen. And structuring the way nature intends it is the way that we get these two molecules in a form that we can use.
There's a little picture on the telestrator here where you can see the water.
The vortex action.
The vortex, and this is how water actually gets structured when it tumbles over waterfalls and things like that. And it just does this naturally in the ocean, of course, all the waves.
And we're at the theragoods.com website. We're on the blog. And at TheraH2O, you know, they've got a pitcher that just the action of the pouring tumbles it, but they actually have a countertop unit that comes with the vortexing.
Right.
But really what's in it is the science of what Robbie's done in the filtration, the eight-stage filtration, the gemstone technology, the infrared technology. It's just great stuff. But I want to just read you from this article. When nature has her way with it, water is hydrating and energizing. Nature adds a healthy spin and movement through vortexing. The water molecule binds with trace minerals from the earth to naturally balance pH and alkalinity. She combines six of the hydrogen atoms into hexagonal crystalline microclusters, H3O2, and these more easily penetrate cell membranes. To be sure, when we get regular bulk water, mm-hmm. whether it be from the tap or the bottle or your RO system or your distiller, the body will use it, but it expends tremendous energy transforming it, being an alchemist, and transforming it into the structured form that is what our cells need. Make sense?
Yeah, structured water.
And this
water
is what they're calling easy mm-hmm. or next level water. I just want to structured, coherent, easy. All of this is the same thing.
All of those terms. Structured mm-hmm. water is needed to restore vital hydration. In fact, once you begin giving your body the water form it needs, hydration can occur drinking less water. If we are nearly 80% water, structured water that is, it doesn't make sense that we should put that back into our bodies. In other words, the regular water that we're drinking may not be structured water, not as good for us.
Have you ever heard a lot of people that say, oh, I'm really drinking water, but I have to go to the bathroom constantly? The body's saying, I don't know what to do with this.
Mm-hmm.
And it's too much of a stress to structure it. So how easy is it to structure it? Whether you're getting your water from a distiller, whether you're getting it from Mountain Valley, whether you're getting it from the tap, because now we find out that the tap is actually safer than the plastic crinkly bottles, mm-hmm. then go ahead and just run it through your structure. I mean, it's great. And then extra filter it, you know?
Yeah.
So, you know, again, some of the drawbacks of plastic bottled waters, toxic petrochemicals and endocrine disruptors. They pollute the environment, and they're not cost-effective, quite frankly. And although we know tap water is not perfect, there's an aging infrastructure. We've been talking about the aging mm-hmm. pipes. We'll talk more about that.
Yep.
There's many pollutants that escape your city's municipal filtration. And then the cities are adding back dangerous chemicals like fluoride and chlorine. So what do? Maybe it is a good idea to get it through your city from a cost standpoint, but then at the point that you know it's being filtered, run it yeah. through something
or
like that.
At the point of the end of the show. Folks, thanks a lot for sticking around. Really, really appreciate it.
And we're into making sure that you stay healthy, and we'll see you next time. So in the meantime, get our Primal Edge, subscribe to the newsletter, and we'll see you next time. Stay healthy.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
You're watching Tiger TV.